Southwest Florida. Welcome back to Lee Pitts Live. We're here at the famed Black History Museum in Fort Myers in Clemente Park. It is the Williams Academy portion of it that we're in. That classroom that you see in the back of me was the class, a replica, the setting of this school, which was the only school that black people could go to before integration. So at the turn of the 20th century, the beginning of the 20th century, during segregation, this is where people came to go to school. And we're so thrilled to have the TV show here. We come here from time to time, at least once a year, because it's my favorite place to take the show. Because without a school like this, and without integration and opportunities that were provided, that are documented here at this museum, you would not see my black face on TV right now. Facts, as they say on social media. Now, let me turn to another handsome black face. No, not another, the handsome black face. I'm not handsome. Barnard Faithful. Man, let me bump you in, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Barnard, man, you've been on the show before, but I'm glad to get you in here in our former show. So good to have a cat like you who I have even seen out already trying to help people as a result of Hurricane Ian. I think I saw you on a pitch or something serving food or doing something. That's just who you are, right?
Absolutely. And they call me the Faithful Community Realtor. Okay. And the way I got that name is just I'm always in the community. Rather what city I'm in, I told you that when we first met. I gotta find certain things in the community, and once I find that, that's what I do. It's just something that I'm programmed to be a part of and just be around my people and be around people in general. Mm. So I wanna say first and foremost is Mr. Lee Pitts, I appreciate you and giving me the opportunity to come on this show. You have had some great people on this show. As the first time I noticed who you were and found you, I was looking at the show and I came across the show and I'm like, I need to go meet that guy.
Well, you met me and we become really good friends over the years. You've always been supportive. We got that Detroit relationship. I used to live in Detroit. I wasn't born and raised, of course, I'm from Birmingham. Uh-huh. And you born and raised, I think, in Detroit.
Born and raised in Detroit.
And let's shout out our boy, Ty Befford.
Oh, yeah,
Ty. Mr. Detroit himself.
Yes, sir.
Dr. That's my Detroit.
Guy. That's my guy.
Hey. And Ty Belford's wife does some financing. I'm sure you guys are probably hooked up together. Pam, I'm shouting you out.
Yes.
Her Pam mortgage company.
Pam is great. We had they actually came to one of my open house before, and we had probably a two-hour conversation.
Okay.
Just encouraging each other, just lifting each other up, and just talking about business.
That's what I'm talking about.
Absolutely.
So you're a realtor with, you're a real estate agent with Royal Real Estate Florida Inc. Tell us what that is.
So Royal Real Estate Inc. is based out of Naples. I am a part of Naples Area Board of Realtors, and we basically help individuals with real estate properties, whether that's commercial, whether that's residential, whether that's finding land and things like that. So
I saw you in Starbucks. I knew you were closing deals, making calls, showing property, man. That's kind of fits your personality, though, showing properties, meeting strangers, listening to their concerns, being patient. That's I just named a few of those things that I think are great characteristics of a good realtor. What are some other things you think that makes a great realtor and that you possess?
I possess patience. I possess building a rapport fast and quick as possible. So to get a person to actually trust me with all the information that they need to give me so I can make that family home a dream home and things like that. A lot of people you deal with in this profession is not a good thing. It's not a good sight because most people are just in it for the money.
Mm-hmm.
With me, of course, I have bills to pay, but at the same time, it's more about building that report. Because if I build that report with an individual, your kid's gonna come to me, their kid's gonna come to me, everybody that they know. So that's my biggest thing. So when we're talking about money, oh yeah, you're gonna make money, but at the same time, you're building a community.
Mm-hmm.
We are the village.
You have access through your real estate company to all of the properties within a certain region or in the state of Florida to purchase or to sell, or lots as well.
Absolutely. So I am part of the MLS. I have access to basically the state. Royal Real Estate is based out of Lee County and Collier County. That's the area that I cover. To try to cover on the East Coast and do all those things, it'd be very, very complicated. But I do have access to that information. mm-hmm. whether it's commercial, whether it's real, residential.
What size properties? What value amounts do you specialize, or everything is open air for you?
Well, the size amount right now is kind of ridiculous because, you know, the prices, inflation, and things like that. But I'm everywhere. I'm trying to help the community out. I'm trying to help the individuals out with the programs that we have. I'm trying to help individuals out find that dream home. So I can be anywhere. I don't limit myself to one thing.
Give a couple of ways that people can contact you.
I'm on social media, Facebook, Bernard.Faithful, all on social media platforms. My cell phone number, personal number is 313-247-8878. 313-247-8878.
They're going to speak directly to you.
Absolutely. You're calling me.
Tell us about the Hometown Heroes program.
So Florida has a Florida Bond has allocated funds to help our heroes, whether that's EMS, whether that's teachers, medical field, all the above. And they have done this to help affordable housing because it's a crisis right now. Mm-hmm. We don't have affordable homes.
So those are people you would identify as well as frontline workers?
Those are frontline workers. And after this hurricane, we may have to add on the electricians and the line workers and things like that, because they are heroes right now also. So it is some qualifications. There's some credit things that you need. You need a 640 credit score household. You need a per income household, 120,000 per household. And just you need to get with someone, a lending company that is officiated with with that program, the Hometown Heroes program.
So what are some of the benefits of the Hometown Heroes program? I don't know if you said, like, is it a no interest, no down payment, low down payment costs? Or
so it helps. It helps with the down payment. A lot of the
closing costs.
Yeah,
as well.
Down payment and closing costs. A lot of people think that the down payment and closing costs is the same thing, and it's not. Mm-hmm. You can have down payment money, but you don't have the closing cost money, and that covers the insurance, everything that you possibly need when a hurricane hits. So they will be able to help you up to about 5%, which is about $25,000. Mm-hmm. And why not take the help?
Still in Southwest Florida area. Lee County, Collier County, we have a lack of inventory. What's the cause of that? Lack of available units to
purchase? Lot of people don't understand that people are having children. The U.S. is building, the population is growing. And what people and what the U.S. have to do is build a certain amount of homes every year. Well, it's been lacking, especially in Florida. About 1,000 people come to Florida every year, move to Florida, transfer to Florida, and we just lack in a home, in basically building homes and residential homes. So this has happened, and then it has not affected. I mean, then you start building residential homes, far as high-end homes, apartment complexes, and you knock out the middle class, the affordable homes. So that's the biggest thing right now. Mm-hmm. They supposed to, by 2023, supposed to build about 3 million homes. Mm-hmm. And that's just where we at right now.
Now, as a result of Hurricane Ian, realtors, are you guys optimistic about the future? Or does it paralyze you in terms of what you're able to do right now?
People are still buying.
Okay.
The only thing that has caused, the Hurricane Ian has caused, is that you need more homes, for one, which we already needed. And then people are looking for rentals, something that can be temporary.
Okay.
Something that they can get in, pay for, and wait for their roofing or the insurance company or FEMA come so they can pay for certain things and fix certain things. So right now, everyone is looking for a rental. And that's a big market right now. The only problem is we were already lacking inventory before the hurricane hit. So
is this still the right time to buy and sell a home?
It is. I believe so, because when you look at the interest rates, as we've been telling people, the interest rate is going to continue to increase and the inventory is decreasing. So if you buy now, you're going to get a better price, because the people that are on the market that's trying to sell, they're going to accept what they can get because they're trying to sell. It's not a lot of people that's going for that property. If you keep waiting, that's an extra, the interest rate go up. If you keep waiting, that's an extra $20,000, $30,000. So why not buy now?
Mm-hmm. What do you think the Hurricane Ian is going to do to property values in the area?
I think it was already adjusting. I don't think it would do anything far as rise, make it rise or anything like that. I think it was already adjusting just how the economy is already. Mm-hmm. So I don't think it's going to affect it that, and that's just my opinion. So.
Where are you moving around? Like, are you getting your vehicle and you're out in the Cape, you're in Lehigh, you're in South Fort Myers, North Fort Myers, you're just surveying things, moving around and looking at property still?
Basically, I'm in Estero.
Okay.
I'm out in Estero, I do some in Naples, I get to Fort Myers pretty often, but during this time, I mean, everybody's doing a great thing in the community, helping each other out. Like I just heard you say, feeding the community. It's hard to get around now because there's no street lights. The four-way traffic right now is, Floridians is not good at the four-way traffic thing. So I try to stay in or go directly to a particular area where I'm trying to basically help out in a community,
that's
serve food, rather that's, you know, doing traffic stuff and I was in Harlem Heights the other day. So
you take that name, I think you said a faithful realtor?
The faithful community realtor.
You take that, a lot of pride in that?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
What is about you that makes you a people person? It's just, you know, in terms of the way you were raised or growing up, or just what makes you care about people?
I think just how I was raised. I'm the oldest of six. So I always had to be the leader. I had to take on responsibilities at an early age. Parents was working, so I had to take on that. I was the first one to go to college, first one to graduate, things like that. So I had to take on responsibility, and I couldn't do it alone. I needed people, and I had to realize that. So I always been just, you know, that person, like, personable, open, caring, all of the above, because I had to be. I needed mentors. I had a lot of great coaches too. Mm-hmm. So I played, you know, professional ball, high school ball, collegiate, and I had a lot of great men in my life that helped me mold into who I am.
I heard you were a decent athlete.
I think I was all right.
Omega Psi Phi too. You want to drop that?
All right.
Okay, we'll let you get that in. Phi Beta in the house. Hey, are we in a recession or a recovery period? What are we going through right now? Or foreclosures?
If someone answers that question, I'll tell you that.
And that's good hands right there, by the way.
You talk about
you saw those hands?
Right?
Go ahead,
bro.
If
they tell you that we are in recession or they know exactly, then I'll say they're lying. We don't know. Do I think that we're going into a recession? I don't believe so.
Okay.
The inflation is here. When the housing market, we talk about the housing market, when people say that, they're talking about foreclosures and things like that. We did have foreclosures in 2007, 2008, when we had the crash. At this time, people crossed their T's, dotted their I's. The lenders did not just give out funds during these times, all right? And most people that purchase these homes pay cash. So we're gonna have foreclosures, but how it was back in those days, I don't believe that will happen.
How does it make you feel when you are able to get somebody into a new home?
Oh,
they turn that key, sold, signed,
It's just the look on their face. It's the smile. They just blessed. They feel, you know, happy. It's amazing, man. To be able to walk in a home and say, hey, this is yours now.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned also that you were raised in, you didn't grow up in an affluent situation, right? You pulled yourself up and you became the successful person that you are. Do you bring that sensitivity with you when you're, say, trying to get somebody into their first time home? They may not have the best credit. They may not have the greatest income. You're still able to work with them to get them into home ownership?
My biggest thing is my team, and I call it Team Faithful. So the people that I surround me, the people that work with me to get you into the home, it's not just me. I don't, you know, but I do have a team and I play sports and that's how I operate. Everyone in my team is trying to get you to that closing table. Everyone in my team is trying to walk you through that process day by day, whatever it takes to get you to that, whether it's 6 months, whether it's 8 months, whether it's a year, we're going to get you there. And that's how I operate.
What do you say to that person who says, I just know I'm never going to be able to get out of rent a house. I'm never going to be able to. I work hard. I do all of this, but I'm never able to get there. Do you say that everybody with proper instructions from you and your team, you can get them into home ownership, condo ownership?
Because I was one of those persons. Same thing. I mean, I'm pretty sure a lot of people believe that you can't do certain things when you don't have the inside scoop or the information or anyone that's guiding you through that process. So that's when the report and the personality that I have with individuals like, hey, come on, let me walk you through it and let's do it.
You mentioned that word patience. That's the key.
Absolutely.
Okay. I want you to take 30 seconds, look into that camera and tell people how to tell people to reach out to you for their home ownership needs.
Listen, you have programs out there, you have opportunities, especially with Hurricane Ian hitting. They're doing things. The state is doing a lot of things for you, your family, and your situation. Contact me. Let's work together. Let's walk through the process. Yeah, you're not probably ready now. Yeah, you probably won't be ready in 6 months. But once we start now, we'll be able to walk you through the process, and I'll be able to hand you that key and say congratulations to you and your family.
Give them that phone number again.
Phone number 313-247-8878. 313-247-8878. Thank you.
Get to talk directly to him. Hey, we're here at the Lee County Black History Museum. More interviews coming up. We're going to be right back. But remember, Miami may have the oranges, but Fort Myers and Southwest Florida and everybody else, including this great realtor, has the
juice.
They still got the juice. We'll be right back.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.